All right, Mr. Leslie, let's get out of here. Ahead, warp factor one.
Warp one, sir.
Everything's all right, Mr. Spock, for us.
There is, of course, no escape for them, sir.
There is, of course, no escape. How would it be? Trapped forever with a raging madman at your throat. Until time itself came to a stop. For eternity. How would it be?
Captain, the universe is safe.
For you and me. But what of Lazarus? What of Lazarus?
Passing through ripples in time.
Maintain orbit. Right here. Open the channel to Starfleet Command. Precautionary measure, Lieutenant. Broadcast to Starfleet Command my past week's log entry, starting with the unusual readings we had on the instruments and how they led us here. Inform Starfleet Command that apparently something or someone down on this planet... Boss. changes in time, causing turbulent waves of space displacement.
Some heart flutter. Better risk a few drops of cordrazine.
It's tricky stuff. Are you sure you want to risk?
Oh, my.
You were about to make a medical comment, Jim.
Who, me, Doctor?
We're driving around most of the time, Ripples, now, Captain.
That's fine. All plotted but one, Captain. Coming up on it now. Seems to be fairly heavy displacement. Halt!
Thank you, physicians.
Valuable, Captain.
It was set for cortisone.
Empty.
Communications, emergency medical team.
Frontier. These are the voyages of the starship Enterprise. Its five-year mission, to explore strange new worlds, to seek out new life and new civilizations, to boldly go where no man has gone before. Supplemental entry. Two drops of cortisone can save a man's life. 100 times that amount has just accidentally been pumped into Dr. McCoy's body. And in a strange, wild frenzy, he has fled the ship's bridge. All connecting decks have been placed on alert. We have no way of knowing if the madness is permanent or temporary or in what direction it will drive McCoy.